Hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Today I'm gonna show for Mike how to download and check Linux Mint on Windows 10. Michael is absolutely newbie, and all he knows about Linux only that Linux quite virus resistant and very stable. Am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. What we're gonna do? If you put in a search line in any search machine, Linux Mint, anytime you're gonna go here. It's a download page, and from a download section, you can download different kind of Linux Mint. The best way. Cinnamon, but many people likes Mate. People who's got very low computers, they prefer to install XFACE because it takes a bit less system resources. And KDE translated like cool desktop environment, but I cannot see anything cool in this one. So, we're gonna download this file, 64-bit version. For downloading, two ways I can use or torrent or just straight download from any country. Our country, we are located, I suppose, in UK.
In the UK, yeah.
In the UK. No, Bytemark. Very well known, and University of Kent, any. Well, for example, I press University of Kent. And what we're gonna do now, I'm just gonna download this file. Later on, we will check this file on a virtual box. Then we can burn it to USB, start from USB, and have a look how it works straight from USB, and if we like it, we can just put this install this system on your hard drive. That is a very simple task for today. Now I'm just gonna make a little break until the file will be downloaded. Later on, we gonna back from Michael. Type test, please. Yeah. And there I'll pick Linux. Oh no, 64 bit. Next. This one usually I do very close to the edge of green border. Create. Agree. 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 Now I'm just going to do a few just. Additional settings like system processor. I've got four processors because I'm gonna give two for these purposes, and just like around 80% display very close to the maximum. And storage, we're gonna pick our storage from here. It was in the downloads folder, downloads. This one, open. That's it. Everything's done, and now we are going to check either image, is it normal or it's broken? How does it work? Just press start button and we'll just have a look what's going on.
Had snow here today, haven't we?
Yeah. Now, what you see, usually I'll take this one. Like this. Linux Mint is starting. If it's starting, that means image wasn't been damaged. It's a normal ISA image. And if it will boot properly, only one meaning we can burn this image to USB drive. Linux Mint. If remember just one simple rule. If ISA image starts to work on a VirtualBox, that means ISA image itself not damaged. It's in a fully working condition and it can be written to any USB. And if you cannot start from USB, just only two reasons. Or your USB is broken, or you have to set up your BIOS to let start from USB. That's it. Okay, this part of video is done. Now what we're gonna do, we're going to write this ISA image straight to you to USB drive. Okay. Now I'm going to make a small introduction for my friend Michael. He's an actor.
Yeah.
And he did play a long time ago, but he did play in a movie called
Inquisitor.
Warhammer.
In Warhammer, which is a games.
Which is a game.
Games company.
Yeah. You can see exactly his name on this film, Mike Dwerryhaus. He lives in Liverpool and he's a friend of mine, a very good man. And
this has got, it's got Russian and Ukrainian subtitles on one of the others, hasn't it?
Oh, it's good.
There's a spoof version.
Yeah. And some people can watch spoof versions of this video in Russian and Ukraine language. It's just a little bit about Michael, but we decided to make this video how to install Linux on your computer, how to run it, and at least to have just to get a little knowledge about what is it.
Yeah.
Because the most of the people, they don't know what is it Linux. Linux is absolutely free operating system.
It's like Google then?
No. Windows is Macintosh, Apple. Yeah. It's operating systems.
Yeah.
Linux is another operating system.
So what would be the equivalent in England?
Anybody all around the world can download Linux Mint, despite of their languages, because you can use Linux Mint on the different languages.
Yeah.
If you British, you can install British language, English language.
Yeah.
If you American, you can use American language.
Yeah.
If you Polish, you can use Polish language. If you Russian, you can use Russian language. It's just very simple to do on Linux.
Yeah.
It's a very friendly operating system, and I use it quite a long time, and I quite enjoy with this system. And now we just decided to make a short video to give you some knowledge. What is it, Linux Mint? All right, next part of our video. What we are going to do now, we're going to download a program called Rufus and run this program. This program doesn't need any installation, just run, and we can write this either image straight to my USB drive. Before you type it, Rufus. Yeah. But we can see exactly we're going to this address, a bit scroll down, and you see Rufus download. The, for today, the last version is 2.18. We're just going to download it, save. It's very small size, practically it's downloaded immediately. You see, nearly done. Show in folder. I'm just going in a folder. And from here, I'm going right button click. Send to desktop. That's it. What we're going to do now, this is Rufus. And I'm going to start this program. And what we have to do, I'm going to insert my USB. Now you can see my USB drive. And now I'm going to find either image and folder downloads. Folder downloads was in there. Linux Mint, open. Usually I use FAT32, right? And there are a few options, but you should be careful. MBR, it's for old machines, but modern computers, most of the modern computers, they've got a GPT partition table. You have to check it before. Yeah, I'm installing just usually on this option, MBR. Now, what will be done? A quick format, and this Linux Mint Cinnamon will be written on this USB drive. Start. Okay. 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 And process is started. When it's finished, I'm going back to my video. Image been written on a USB drive. You can see the word is ready. All you have to do just close it. Now, many people, they don't know how to start a USB from your computer because there are different brands of computers and you should find out how can you start this USB from your personal computer? How to boot from USB? What do you say?
From the USB.
Put it down.
USB.
How to boot from USB?
How to boot from USB.
You will see a huge list of different methods how to boot from USB, and you can find what is much more suitable for you. Next lesson. So we can see my hard drive, and practically it's Windows 10 installed, then Linux Mint, Cinnamon, as well as swap file. And home folder for Linux Mint. And I've got four empty partitions where can I install any Linux. What I'm going to do, I'm going to install Linux Mint just straight in one partition size 50 gigabyte,
And I'm not going to divide it to the root and home. I'm just going to install it straight. How? We can see this small picture on the screen called
install
Linux Mint. Double click on it. In English language, I just pick English language, continue. I'm just gonna mark this one, third party software install, I don't mind. Now we have to wait a bit because it just take a while until installation will search through all your hard drive and determine which software need to be installed exactly on your
right place.
On your computer. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now you got a message saying agree. UEFI mode, I don't mind. Finally, we've got the type of installation and I'm going to pick something else. Continue. And I'm going to pick at least swap file and one partition size 50 gigabyte where I'm going to install Linux Mint. Swap file gonna be in there. I'm just gonna check, do I need something? No, it will do automatically. What I got, four empty partitions, SDA8, 9, 10 and 11. I can install Linux on any of these. I'm just going this way, change. Do not use this partition. I will use this partition as EX4 format and do it root. Symbol for the root is just slash. Okay. And we see it's going to be a small cross.
Yeah.
And just install now. Swap file going to be connected the root partition. Continue. That's it. What we've done? We've made a special or created special place where we're going to install Linux Mint, and now we're just installing Linux Mint on this partition. No, now just London, UK, continue if you live in another country, pick your own position. Keyboard, keyboard layout, no. English UK, no questions. In there, usually I pick username like a user. But for private purposes, I'm just going to put Michael, put your name, Mike. Yeah. And in there, I'm going to pick a very short password later on when everything's going to be...
It's not Penguin, is it?
No. Just I'm going to make sure password 1 and 1 and log in automatically.
Yeah.
And continue.
Your little monocle's a penguin, isn't it?
I can put any, but what I'm gonna do, when we install Linux Mint on a hard drive, additionally, we will need to install a lot of different programs. It's up to you or from your taste, etc. And every time to put 8 or 20 symbols password, it's just too boring.
Yeah.
That is why I make a password for the first time very short. Digit 1. When everything is done, I can make my password 20 or 30 symbols long. Doesn't matter. Now we're just watching the installation process. Usually it takes 10-15 minutes, no more. And when we finish, we're going to start not from USB, we're going to start from a fresh installation from our computer. That's it. Because what we've done, we downloaded the official distribution of Linux Mint on Windows 10. We did check this ISO image on VirtualBox. When we've checked it, we did write it to USB drive using a program called Rufus. Now we started from USB drive. We've made we pick a special partition. We are going to install Linux Mint, and now we are in the process of installing Linux Mint on this partition. When installation will be finished, we're going to switch off computer. I'm going to take USB out of the socket and restart computer, and we will see what's going to happen next. Right. So we been lucky. We've been lucky, and we started from this partition, and practically Linux Mint been installed on this hard drive, and now we will do step-by-step installations of different programs which Michael will consider will suit for him. Okay.
Yeah.
What we're gonna do now? First, the program to let you watch all your partitions gonna be GP. In here, at least. Number one. Program called GPATIT, it's a partition manager. It lets you see all your partitions on your hard drive. But from here I can see SDA8. It's exactly this partition where Linux Mint been installed.
Yeah.
Right, this is one I can unmount it, don't need it. Another partition, swap file, and partition extended, been connected. That is why. What we're gonna do now? We are going to install some programs. For example, Michael likes to do video edition software, and we've got normal soft in here. I'm just going to show you very simple what we can This program for Linux, it lets you make any video editing called OpenShot. Just type in there, OpenShot, and press Enter. SH. Yeah, it is. That one. I'm just pressing install button and just continue number one. What can I say? Michael just did try to use Linux for the first time in your life.
Yes.
And did you find it difficult?
No. I found it quite good. It's relatively hassle free, isn't it? You don't get any hassle.
No.
Using it.
Especially if you've got a friend who can give you a hand, or Linux itself got huge societies.
Yeah.
A lot of forums on the different languages. So you always can ask for a help, and you've been given this help.
Yeah.
Now, OpenShot, nearly finished. Now, I'm just going to check what we've got. Sound. Open shot, video editor, no, I can put it in there, for example, and I'm just gonna start it. And it's just a standard mistake. You can find a plugin, Free0R. What this plugin? All you have to do, just only to mark it, and I can close it for a while. AOR, and this one. It's additional plugin, and it will let you play good. And now I'm sure video editor OpenShot will work fine. I'm just going to start it. This one?
Yeah.
OpenShot. And no more any hassle messages on the screen. Now next part of video, I will show you how to cut the video on a different on a small pieces and how to stick them. Now just I'm going to make a little break. File, recent files, this one. Oh, you see how much it didn't take. I can stay just on a small piece below, and the small piece in there, right? That one, I'm just gonna remove it. That one, I'm just gonna to remove it. And all you have to do just
put them together.
Put them together, save. And now what we're gonna do, as well, I stay on a you see, normal. Put it on a very low.
Yeah.
Open shot, right button click, change priority, and a very low. That's it. Now, what we're gonna do? Profile, Blu-ray, and quality high. Export. Change, replace, and let it go. It's going to be a small part of video, but the main thing to show you how can you cut it from any side and how can you stick it, save it and produce a video. One folder is enough. This one. We can wait. Right, now what we're gonna do, Michael, we are going to install a special program. I like to use this program for watching my videos. First of all, I have to run Cherry Tree. Now program called SM Player, and now you're gonna install it by yourself because you know the principles. All you have to do to mark these lines,
yeah.
1, 2, 3,
yeah.
4,
yeah.
And install it.
Yeah.
Come on. Do it.
Okay.
All right. Enter. Password.
11.
One.
One.
Enter. Enter. Second line. Right, just give me a sec. Right, tell me, was it so difficult to mark this line and to transfer them?
No, it was easy.
Now you're gonna do the same with the third line?
Sure.
Yeah, this one. Cool. Enter, yeah. Many people, they just scaring to use
technophobes.
Yeah. I meant scaring to use a terminal. Sometimes people call it console. Right. But as you see, nothing difficult, and mark and copy paste the last command, SMTube. It's additional program, for this video player. It's like additional program, but I'll show you all benefits of this program, because usually I use both of these programs. All right, now we can close terminal. We can go audio and video, SM player. And this program looks like this. If you want to open any file for watching, you have to go to videos. What we've got, I'm not sure will it work or not. And now I'm just going to show you how program SM Player works. We're going on sound and video, picking SM Player, and it's very funny and good button, YouTube browser. you press it, and do me a favor, Michael, or group or song, what you like.
Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan.
Dylan.
And which one?
Times they are changing.
This one, 50 minutes too long.
This one.
This one.
Yeah.
It's called The Times They Are Changing.
Yeah.
Right. You stop it, went to a cheapest shop, then back, open menu, sound and video, SM player, and going on your favorites, and Bob Dylan.
Yeah.
At your service. The same way you can make very good collections of different videos.
Yeah.
It's just up to you. That is why I prefer to use a simple screen, SM player, because together with YouTube browser, it...
But you know, like on Google, for instance, on your YouTube site, you have a list, you can watch a YouTube video and just pop it on your favorite songs on YouTube. It's quick, isn't it?
No,
but this is private.
It's a private.
Yeah,
it's, you know, like it's absolutely privacy. Just only you know what you like, etc.
Yeah.
On YouTube, you know, it's like a community. Everybody can see what you like, what you don't like, etc. It's just a bit more privacy, exactly. So, I'm not going to explain how to install every single program on Linux, because there is a lot of different programs, and on Linux it could be installed this way. Menu, first of all, Software Manager. It's a main source. It's a lot of probably 20,000 or 30,000 different programs can be taken from here and installed absolutely for free. Another way to install program from Synaptic, from Debian files, and from console terminal. It's up to you. Different sources. In here, what you can see, just by groups, even games, a lot of games. If you like gaming, you can install Vine. It's a Vine will let you play many games which you play on Windows as well. And its name, you see. Different kind of games. A lot of different programs, but practically it's absolutely free. That is why people like Linux, and for users, I should say for ordinary users, I think it's more preferable operating system, because you don't have to pay for operating system itself. You don't have to pay for programs. You don't need to use antivirus software. Practically for all these years I never use antivirus software on my Linux, but it works fine. I call it like a tractor. Sometimes my desktop been switched on for a couple of weeks and it did work like a tractor. Well, lovely operating system. I think this is a our small introduction into Linux world, especially been done by Michael, because he was absolutely newbie, and you see, and he is not technical person, because he's an actor, but practically he picked everything from just you know, from the scratch.
Thanks for this introduction, Alexei. Thank you very much, and thank you for the people who view it.
You're very welcome. Okay.